To Battleground Nova Scotia now, where the NDP government of Daryl Dexter celebrated 4 years in office this week. Dexter has to call an election before his fifth anniversary in office, and that means everyone is in high election readiness, nominating candidates, putting new ideas before voters. Now, one of those new ideas is coming from progressive conservative leader Jamie Baillie in the wake of the resignation of MLA Trevor Zink. Zink was elected a New Democrat in 2006 and again in 2009, but in 2010, he was kicked out of the NDP caucus over irregularities with his expenses. Well, those irregularities turned into criminal charges, and this week, Zink pled guilty to fraud and breach of trust and then resigned his seat, keeping a $51,000 transition payment before he would have been kicked out of the legislature, forfeiting that transition payment. Well, the aforementioned Jamie Baillie of the Nova Scotia PCs joins us via Skype now. And I guess, first of all, Jamie, what did you think of this whole Zink affair?
Look, David, it just it makes me sick because for all of those Nova Scotians and Canadians that are watching these things happen here in the legislature in Nova Scotia or even in other places across the country, they just continuously get the message that there seems to be one set of rules for elected politicians and a different set of rules for everybody else, and that's just wrong. That's what has to be fixed if we're going to get the root of all of these problems.
One of the excuses that Zink gave, which I found, I don't know, I won't say amusing, but I found interesting, let's put it that way. He says he resigned so that the legislature wouldn't take away the funds for his office. Those funds were being used to pay the salary of one of his staff, a single mother. So, in other words, Zink saying, I'm sorry, I have to take this $51,000 lest an employee of mine suffer. Do you buy that very much?
Well, no, not at all. To be kind, he's misinformed. His employees are employees of the government. They will, of course, be treated fairly and looked after. They haven't done anything wrong. His office, his constituents, they'll get looked after. The severance payment that's today's issue is a payment that he wants to receive for himself, even though he's pled guilty to defrauding the taxpayers. And that, to me, proves the point that we need to make the rules the same in our legislature as everybody else lives by. As you know, every day, millions of Canadians, they go to work, they pay their taxes, they don't steal from the company till, they know they're fired without severance if they do. Those are the kind of rules, that kind of common sense rules, that should apply to the Nova Scotia legislature and MLAs and all of our elected people across the country.
Now, let's talk about the new idea that you're putting forward in the wake of this, which is, whoop, there you are. Are you still there, Jamie?
Yeah, I'm right here.
Okay, sorry. Let's talk about this new idea you've got, which is to essentially take, is to have MLAs' pensions and pay supervised by, if I understand this, a board of independent citizens.
Absolutely right. That to show Nova Scotians that truly they are the boss, that we as politicians work for them, let's put them at the top of the political pyramid. Too often they feel that they're at the bottom, being trampled on when they see these things happen. Let's put them back at the top and have a board of everyday people decide on the pay and the benefits and pensions, if any, and the rules of work for their elected politicians. As you know, David, nowhere else do people get to decide their own pay and their own benefits, and that should be true for our elected people as well.
How would that work if you put it in? Would it be each party might nominate someone for this? You can just see how that might get abused, where a party with a majority puts all their friends and cronies on a particular board like that.
Well, yeah, absolutely. So it has to be completely independent of the politicians themselves. You know, in the legislature here, same as in the House of Commons, there's a committee of MLAs or committee of MPs that set these rules. That's what I mean. Nobody else gets to do that. There's nothing special about being a politician. Same rules should apply. So let's pick a panel of independent people, people I just talked about, that go to work every day, that pay their taxes, that don't steal from the company, that suffer the consequences if they did, and put them in charge of how much we pay our politicians and what rules we live by. I will tell you that a couple of years ago, Nova Scotia had a big expense scandal and some new rules were put in place. And I know that my NDP and Liberal opponents, their leaders, believe that's all that needs to be done and that this could never happen again. But just last month, the Liberal leader here in Nova Scotia gave permission to one of his MLAs to take a month off with pay while the budget was being debated in the legislature. And that doesn't happen in the real world, and it should not be allowed to happen with politicians either.
As I mentioned off the top here, Premier Dexter just did 4 years. He's got to have an election somewhere in the next year. Would you rather have one this summer? Would you rather wait to the fall? Any preference as far as the Nova Scotia PCs are concerned?
Well, I've always been in favor of fixed-date elections. And to me, this odd period in our own province where the government's passed its best-before date, past 4 years, is proof of it. Because Nova Scotians, in my opinion, are ready to pass judgment on the NDP government and their record, which I'll just share quickly with you, is the highest taxes in the country, the highest power rates in the country, a record increase in our provincial debt in 4 years. Nova Scotians are ready to vote on that, and they aren't, because the NDP are going to hold on and hold on and hold on. Greatest argument for fixed state elections I've seen yet.
Well, Jamie Baillie, when and if we do get going, good luck. Thanks for joining us tonight. I appreciate it.
Thank you, David.